Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Solace. It's like 3 in the morning here, a little after. I figured this would be the appropriate time to check out this spooky little cave tunnel thing that we found. So, we are after whatever's that way. Oh, what did I find? Passage of the Travelers. Okay. So we came down the ladder. We saw the save point, went over there. But what we're actually after, what was that? Hold up. Okay, there's something over there, obviously. I don't know how we find that, but explore the lower section. I can't get to the lower section unless there's a switch here. The reason I said it would be appropriate to do it late at night like this is because this is a spooky little cave we got going on. And I thought that, ooh, right here, can be opened. That has something. Strange fruit. Empty pack. What is that? Alien item can be filled. Needs alien food. Drop that on the ground. What? I don't know what that means. What's happening? I don't know what that means. Let me look at this. Okay, so restore pack. Health plus 25. So we put in a strange fruit. Now it's got a little piece missing. I don't know, man. Whatever. It's cool with me. That looks like a switch. It is a switch. Okay. This place is trapped. I don't generally get spooked easily, but I figure if something's going to spook me, it would be in a situation like this. I wanted there to be something back in there, like secret things, but oh, I guess not. Ooh, what's this? I don't know what that means. Oh, this is something. Adar Sum. Is that the name of this place? Or like maybe like the wing? That's what wing we're in? That's red.
Dehydration imminent.
Well, we don't want that. Like, so we're gonna have to go back another way. No, there was another path down by the save point that I didn't take. Did I just miss picking these up because I'm an idiot? I think I did. Oh, wait, hold up. that what activates this? No. I heard something. Maybe the area down here that was blocked off a second ago. We still don't have a ton of water. Wait, is our torch dehydrating us faster? I really hope not. Okay, no, that didn't do anything, it looks like. I mean, no, it did a thing, but it didn't do that thing. I'm sorry, but I gotta have the torch. I can't see really without it. Didn't do that. That activated something. I heard it. But I don't know what. Something. Oh well, looks like we are definitely headed down into save point area. Those are bear traps. Can I drop something onto them? Oh, they just reset themselves, so there's not really any point in it. Okay. Oh, wait, okay. Maybe both of these need to be pushed. Take it. Resistance to dehydration plus one. Okay. Cools. I like it. I bet. Okay, that's what that other switch did that I didn't know. We're gonna go this way. Hey. Nothing. You know, I'm gonna go ahead and take another water. And this light crystal. That's our blinky blinky thing. Food and heat are rare underground. Recover in places like these. Oh, I can just eat it. Okay. Straight up eat and drink here. Empty water bottles. This is so cool. What is this? Is this just a thing that gives off heat and sound, I guess? Not heat and sound, heat and light. I know what I meant. lots of rock over there. This is really cool. Shortage of sleep. Okay, well, that's fine. That is okay by me. I'm way too close to that thing. That thing is very warm. We are full up on inventory, though. I don't think we need these roots. We are short on sleep, so let's go ahead and pop down for like 6 hours. You know what? Let's go ahead and just make it a good 8. Oh, please don't be anything near me.
Okay. Quality, good.
Good sleep quality. Let's go ahead and grab me some of that. And grab me some of that. Sleep quality was 70%, so that's good. Now we've got 9 in-game hours before we need to sleep again. Let's go ahead and pull this thing out so we can see. I heard a sound. Save here. What are you? Passage of the Travelers, 2 of 4. What's this? Genesis? Sages speak of a world before this one, a world that was our home, where we worked the fields under the sun. Okay, that's 7 of 8, so it goes down and then back up. Wait, what? Okay, that's 1 of 8. Where's 2? That's 5. That's 3, 4, 6, 5, 7, 8. Where's the rest of it? Oh, we'll get what we can. So we read that one. One day, the heaven's warmth and life became poisoned. Its celestial wrath made our waters dry, our lands barren. We were forsaken until the coming of the Sky Ones. Which I guess is what this shows. They heard our call. The Sky Ones approached from above, from the divine plane above. Their holy emissary called himself Adar-Sum. The Sky Ones took us on a journey across the black ocean of stars. We ventured down the cortex of days to reach our new home, Galea, which is what that is showing. But where are the other bits? That looks like a button. Do I want to push button? I'm not sure. Adar-Sum. It's obvious. I mean, of course it's obvious, but like, somebody lived here at some point. They really want me to pick up one of these rocks, don't they? Plus 25 health. Empty pack. I hear things moving in the darkness. Oh man. I'm gonna have to run, aren't I? And go! wants me to use the rock for. I suddenly know this. Whoop. Milestone. Passage with the Travelers, number 3. I think we can safely put this away. It seems bright enough in here. That looks like a sword. I'm not gonna pick that up yet. Sky One's number 3, okay. They built a city of stone and showed us how. Their knowledge made our knowledge. We learned how to make the burning ice and the flowing stone. It shows just like pictures of it. I don't really like that. I wish I could hotbar this. I'm not going to touch that sword until I'm ready to leave this place, because who knows what's going to happen. There's another sword here. Useful tool, can cut, can act as leather. This one I'm okay picking up because it's not on some kind of pedestal. The Sky Ones went underground, for that was their home. Our Most Hallowed followed them and became the Enlightened, who spread the wisdom of the Sky Ones. So that's where they're going underground, that's where they got the wisdom and junk.
Objective reminder, locate materials for satellite uplink.
That looks like ice, yo. Sword, 0 more nearby, okay. Okay, I had to stick that in there, and now I'll use it as a lever. I can't get it back. Am I cold? I'm a little chilly. So we'll use this. Uh-oh.
This planet isn't as untouched as we thought. I need to report back. I need to record this. Wilson, record. This is Octavius Skenn, environmental analyst with the Solus III detachment on Gliese 6143C. I landed on an archipelago. Lots of rock and tough flora. As far as the eye can see is shimmering ocean. The atmosphere seems habitable, but it might be volatile. I'll keep gathering data. I followed a strange sound after the crash, which led me into a series of caves. And there's more than just geology and dripping water down here. There are signs of civilization, carvings, mechanisms, buildings. We're not the first beings here. I found a skeleton, a humanoid skeleton, with a strange elongated skull. I don't know what to make of it. Its skeletal structure is so similar to ours. I need to keep going. I'll see if I can find a way to link with the satellite and submit my data. Scan out.
I don't know about you guys, but I just got chills. This game is very, very well put together. I like it a lot. There may be some bugs here and there with like textures or whatever, but so far the writing's great. The voice acting is good. The way you just kind of discover things as we go. Real good. Passage of the Travelers, 4 of 4. Like, the way things are revealed and stuff, it's... Oh, I like it a lot. What's up here? It's so shiny. No, it's just one of those. What is happening up there? Whoa! That scared the crap out of me. I'm too hot now. Can I see? Oh, I can see. Okay. So if you run, you can go right past them. I can no longer see very well, so let me pull this out. I chose this one because it's a little warm down here. Okay, there's it.
Oh no!
I've been shish kebabbed. What's my health looking like? 400? That took off 200? Just sprint, run. Oh man. Woo boy. That's screaming. I just heard screaming. Torch. I need to be able to see further ahead. There's 9 secrets left to be found. Oh man. I only got 1 in that whole area. All I can think of was I got the one that was behind the one that gave me the dehydration resistance. Those freaking spike plants scared me half to death, man. And there's screaming going on in these caves, and there's like some sort of earthquake happening around. Man, this place is absolutely terrifying. I haven't seen an actual enemy at all this entire game, and yet I'm always terrified something's about to get me. That's the sign of a well-made game right there. This loading screen takes a while. Them be some stairs. All right, another save point. Daylight! Do we have any empty bottles on us? We do. We do have 1 empty bottle. Might as well fill it up. Crossing of roads. Number 1. Follow the path and find out where it goes. Inspect the second escape pod crash site. There's a secondary escape pod. Crossing of roads. There's 2 areas in here.
Inventory full.
Well. What can we drop? I think we can drop this rock now. We're gonna munch on that. And we're gonna munch on this. We've got plenty of food. So we don't necessarily need to hoard right now. What's the temperature? It's like 30 degrees, but it's rising. This place is awesome. What was that? Okay, so there's like a we okay? Oh, yeah, we're okay on calories, so we don't really need those. There's something right there, there's something right there, and something over here. Varsa's account. Tales from our elders' tongue speak of working the land high above the sea, sleeping beneath the sun and stars, but Utugu and the enlightened withdraw beneath the surface to the domain of the sky ones. I'm betting that is a tower piece. That blue glow is a tower piece. I'm willing to go ahead and say that. I see our second escape pod. Should have seen that a long time ago. I want to check out this tree. Ah, there's some stuff right there, too. That one's pretty close. I bet there was a path it wanted me to follow, like a specific way to go down through here. Because of that stone plate, I'm willing to bet that that's a thing, but oh well. Right, I will be with you in a second. I'm going down next to the ocean. I'm less scared of the ocean now, after being down there. At some point, maybe on my own time, once the playthrough is over, I'll have to go down and explore everything and try to get all of the secrets and things that are down there. See, I know there's got to be something here among these rocks somewhere. Ooh, look at that. See? Gravestone. Here lies Scylla the Fisherman, left this world aged 40 on Galea, 16 years after the Exodus. Okay. Gravestone on the beach. Not the coolest thing we've seen. I'm looking for secrets, like, resistances and like backpacks and things. There might be a backpack over there by the escape pod. We'll go check that out. What is happening? Nothing is happening? I really, 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 really want to go over there. Let's go to the escape pod like at once. I'm the kind of guy that I just want to go through and look at every little thing all the time. I'm willing to bet we're going to find like water bottles and food and stuff here as well. Yura's Crash Diary. All those years we spent traveling, getting to know each other, researching, all that hope, vanished as the ship went up in flames. I don't know what happened. All I know is that everything's lost. Mira, it was for nothing. I should have called you. Or wait, Maria, not Mira. I have never felt so alone in my life. I keep wandering around on this strange island, asking myself if I should try to find everyone. They deserve some sort of memorial. Half of them are probably in the sea. Yeah, probably. As much ocean as there is on this planet. Not sure what good it will do, but I'll try to establish a comms link with Prolus. The satellite probe in orbit can serve as a communication relay, but I'll have to scavenge some parts so I can send a signal from the surface. I wonder how the other ships fared. Selected a site on top of the hill for the communication tower. A good landmark. Perhaps if someone's still alive, they'll notice it up there. If my arm wasn't broken, this would all be easier. I think the wound on my stomach is also becoming infected. What landmark? I don't see anything yet. That's a green glow over there. I'm jealous of the rest of the crew, the now-dead crew. Ha, at least they didn't have to die alone. To witness all this, Maria, it deserves to know what happened. I suppose everyone does, so I'll keep trying. I've scavenged most parts of the ship from this island, but I haven't found any bodies. I know that they're all dead, yet there isn't a single corpse. Where are they? I thought the module Amon and Fred were in came down intact, too. I'm not Amon nor Fred, so I don't know who they will be. Two beacons, two med packs, two backpacks, a lighter, a flashlight, glow sticks, a mask, and battery. I've collected all the basic components to start on the communications tower. My main goal is to let the people of Prolus Colony know what happened. I've had a fire going these last days to signal anyone alive. Maybe they're on other islands. Grab the beacon. What do I do with that? Oh, it's a glow stick. What can I get rid of for the glow stick? You know what? Let's go ahead and eat these.
Operator health improved. Operator health improved.
You never know. You might need a glow stick. Can I throw it? No, I can just drop it. What the crap? Oh, water bottles, food cans and stuff. Of course it wasn't going to be that easy. Tried sending a basic emergency message, but the signal was too weak. I jumped the gun. Need to find better, proper tool parts so that I can boost the signal and find a way to make more sophisticated messages. Oh no. I swear I saw light at a distant island. I rubbed my eyes red trying to see clearly. I swear something was there. I tried to signal back, making reflections with a metal shard, but nothing happened. Maybe it was my imagination. Do I need food? I do need food. I don't need 2,000 calories worth of food, though. That would be a waste. It has to be real. Keep seeing it. Light on the other island. But even if they, or it, saw my signal, they might not have understood or had any method of signaling back. Funny, this diary has truly become my confidant. Who'd have thought?
Yuri.
Pipe. Need more parts to upgrade the transmitter. Then I can tell them what happened. All the people who thought of us for 15 of their years, 8 of mine, but I can't work alone for much longer, becoming far too weak. I can't bend over on my stomach, the pain. Lighter? Lights things. Rare. Okay, we want that. We want the circuit board. Pull up on that. That scared the crap out of me. Right. I entered a cave to escape a storm, slipped and wrenched my leg between two rocks, broken. Managed to make it back to camp with great difficulty in 2 hours. This is the end. I was coming back after finding a drop pod intact. Is somebody in there? Is one of the team alive? Perhaps kept asleep by an emergency life support? And I never knew. Okay. Well, there's 11. Okay, we read 12 over there. So 13. Or did we read? Did we read 12 over there? We might have. All this food and water. It'll have to stay here. This will be my base for now. Yeah, that was 11. 11. They've already got themselves a good torch. So that's 13, 12. Okay, yeah, so that's 12. Okay, 13. Harder and harder to stay awake. wounds truly beginning to take their toll. Stomach infection, especially. Only hope now is to keep writing, and that someone will find this journey. Trying to prolong my life in ink. Thank God for impervious paper. One can't stop looking at one's wounds. Human condition, fascination with the morbid, but the smell is something no one could possibly ignore. I never knew an injury could produce such a stench. If only I had meds. Perhaps if the person in the drug pod is alive. The line between reality and my imagination is becoming blurrier. I thought I had written more detailed entries, about how I'm building communication power. Was that in my head? Did I lose those pages? Didn't someone once say that imagination is a survival mechanism? Only fitting that a narcissist would die alone. Last thoughts are with you. Sorry I left. What a waste. 15 years. The trauma of leaving. I regret it all. I regret not being able to spend my final moments with you. I'm so sorry. I am so, so sorry. Another glow stick.
Inventory full.
Flashlight. Just get rid of that. Pick up the flashlight. I'm so sorry. But that's where we're going to have to call it today, guys. More earthquakes are happening. Again, it's another 1 hour and 7 minutes, or 1.6 hours now before we need sleep. So let's just go ahead and do it now. See, shortage of sleep. It knows what I'm thinking. What's the longest we can sleep? I'm curious. 10? Well, we're going to go ahead and do 10 hours. We're going to go to sleep. It'll probably be cold, but they've got a good fire going here. Hopefully that won't burn out on us. If it does, there's plenty of things around to make a new fire. See, it doesn't seem to be burning out, so that's fine. Why is my health down?
Dehydration imminent.
Oh, that would be a good reason.
Emergency. Hydration levels critical. Seek water source.
And same thing for food. Let's go ahead and pop this open. Drop that down. All right. So that'll do it, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed the episode. If you did, hit that like button, comment, subscribe if you want to see more in the future, and I will see you next time.